Japan. The world truly exists as a wonderful art. Different ecosystems exist for every different wildlife in a variety of habitats. As we glance upon the night sky, a vague universe gives sparkles of beautiful lights reflecting through our own eyes. Cooling oxygen that travels throughout our respiratory system as we witness the greenery of a forest giving life to every human being. But what if this world we are currently roaming around is being slowly destroyed and results to global warming, ice melting at the Antarctic region, and lastly, natural disasters. And the saddest part about that is that we humans and our activities are mostly the causes of it. From a paper conducted by a group of researchers, let's first progress our understanding to the question, are we invasive? Dividing the progress into three topics, let's hear the voices of the researchers who conducted this research to spread the awareness regarding invasive species.
Organisms that aren't endemic to the region and cause harm to its environment by disrupting natural cycles, altering natural habitats, and leading essential plants and animals to extinction. These organisms typically are introduced by accidental spread, by ships and boats coming from other places, and most often by people. Invasive species are harmful, since they have a dramatic effect on the Earth's natural resources, environment, human health, and economy.
The effects of the invasive species in the ecosystem reduces the streams in making historical water deliveries. It displaces native plant communities that they invade and change the nature of the habitat. It may also cause the extinction of native species. Prime examples of these invasive species are green crab, killer algae, sea walnut, veined rapa, and sea mussel.
The sedimentary cycle is the weathering of an existing rock, followed by the erosion of minerals. At the same time, this includes elements such as iron, calcium, phosphorus, sulfur, and other more earthbound elements. Rocks break down in a process called weathering, where an existing rock erodes, releasing minerals from the Earth's crust in the form of salts, some of which dissolve in water that passes through different kinds of organisms, and ultimately reaches the deep seas, where they settle out in circulation indefinitely. The sediment and rock in shallow seas eventually weather and cycle. Some plants and animals obtain their nutrients from the cycles, such as when the plants absorb the nutrients and the animals that eat the plant. The phosphorus cycle, it is usually found as a phosphate ion commonly found in sedimentary rocks. As the rock weathers down over a long period, it can leach to the surface water and soil in which plants can absorb the soil. And while the quantities of phosphorus in the soil are generally small, which can often limit plant growth, farmers often apply phosphate fertilizers on farmland. The transfer of phosphate happens when plant absorbs the phosphate in the ground and the animals eat the plant.
Humans had colonized every continent except Antarctica by roughly 15,000 years ago. Therefore, an invading species must be non-native. Sure, we've arranged our populations and had population explosions since then, but we're still a native species. Humans satisfy this portion of the description in too many ways to name. An invasive species has negative consequences on its new environment and or human health. An invasive species is any living organism that is not native to an environment and causes harm, such as cane toad, a plant, insect, fish, fungus, bacterium, or even an organism, seeds, or eggs. They can have negative consequences for the environment, the economy, and even human health. Invasive species are those that grow and reproduce swiftly, spread aggressively, and have the potential to threaten humans.
The reliance of humans on agriculture has been a major impact on human civilization. And with advances in human knowledge, we have discovered substances that allow plants to gather more nutrients. This substance is what we call fertilizers. And these fertilizers contain phosphorus, which would be harmless had it not been washed off of plants and reach bodies of water. This results in an overabundance of nutrients for plants, and in turn, would increase the population of algae. This algae will eventually die and create algae blooms, which will make the surrounding environment toxic to aquatic plants and animals. Human progress in agriculture and the constant changing of landscapes has led to changes in fluvial processes, thus resulting in either aggradation or degradation of morphological structures in rivers and coastlines. Us humans already know this problem and have a lot of scientific discoveries on how to fix the problem back to its original self. But as we continue to grow, we continue to destroy these cycles, and just like the by changing the phosphorus cycle by providing phosphorus for agricultural production and removing phosphorus through soil management methods, resulting in erosion and leaching. Reducing phosphorus from ecosystems. Human manipulation of the phosphorus cycle has a severe influence on the environment and future food production. This simply means that our biodiversity will be progressively depleted and degraded as a result of how we do things and harvest the resources that are required for our planet's health.
In your farm, if we would further our interest in indulging on our own selfish interests, as it prosper our individual and private business, then we shouldn't be questioning amongst ourselves the slow changes we are facing in a daily basis. The future would be bright and clear as it leads us to our own doom. If we would convert the damage done to our environment, it would cost us around $1.4 trillion annually. So, what are the steps we take to mitigate the damage we've done? One of the solutions seen is responsible mining, where minerals are mined slowly. And there will be environmental plans when the minerals have been exhausted. While for agriculture, much more efficient use of phosphate is needed by increasing the efficiency in using phosphorus, mostly in arable land, and using other alternative fertilizers such as excrement from animals to minimize the need for mined phosphate. At the same time, human manipulation of waterways has caused a bloom of growth of aquatic plants and algae when there is too much phosphate in the water. And it can speed up eutrophication, in which proper water treatment should be utilized as a way in preventing contaminated waters from contaminating the rivers and lakes. Going back to the original question, are we invasive? In my opinion, we may not harness the complete criteria for being invasive as we are native species, and thus we are something far greater and dangerous than invasive species alone, for we are destructive species. We truly inherited the 6 catalysts for mass extinction, human beings. So let's not suffice ourselves to our own interests, but we unite as one to help this dying world to become prosperous and wealthy once again.